Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player. Good day, all. Ira Epstein of Lunan Associates with your agriculture update for this Thursday, the 21st of September, 2017, just getting on the 1:30 p.m. Central Daylight Time. I'm very early. I want to wish everybody a happy Jewish New Year, and I'm out the door right after this. So in looking at the markets today, it's the event that we're going to be looking at is this afternoon at 2 o'clock. Steve Mnuchin's going to come on and talk about sanctions and how the U.S. is going to sanction North Korea. The Jewish holiday is the next part of the event because you saw some trading volume on the morning, and then it quickly, volatility and volume fell off rather dramatically as most Jewish people are headed to their synagogues, and then they'll have their dinners tonight. The ultra-Orthodox won't even be back tomorrow. Most of the other Jewish people will, and then they'll wait for the next holiday, the Yom Kippur. But at this point, Happy New Year to all. As you can see, the stock market took into stride everything today in terms of the Fed talking about 6 interest rate hikes, the dollar down 27. And I mentioned that all because it does play out in the grains. You saw that the cotton got hit with the idea that we'd have a stronger dollar. The sugar market and most of the energy are down a tad as well. When we come to the soybean chart, and that's what we're focusing on, we had an outside day up, and as long as you don't take out this low by tomorrow, this market, the chances of it still trying to follow through are pretty darn good on the weekly chart. When we come to a November chart, daily area chart, you can see how the market's going from 33 to 78 and a quarter, and it's about 8 cents off that high, just sort of sitting right here. And we have the sideways action. You can actually look at how the market's narrowing in with a trading top there and a bottom there. It's forming a triangle, if you will. It's going to break out one way or the other, so keep your eyes on it. Some of the tip-offs might be taking out 958 and a half, the swing line low, to put the trend back down, or getting over 974, and as long as you don't take out today's low from there, the market might break out then to the upside. I'd be looking at both numbers. The support in the market's pretty clear. It's the combination of the 100-day average and the 18. Should the market break down, that's your first support. Take out that 58 and a half, you're under both numbers. That would be a bit bearish. Hold that number and then take off up here, bullish, and you don't even have to come back to challenge it since you did that 2 days ago. When you take a look at Bollinger Bands, I'm looking for the resistance at the top band if the market tries to get over 74, up at that 84 and a half level. In terms of momentum, what's bothered me and will continue to bother me is how overbought you are and the fact that the momentum indexes are not trying to embed just yet. It's just overbought. In the meal market, the resistance is pretty clear. It's the 100-day average of closes along with the upper Bollinger Band at 312.90, again, an overbought condition. In the soybean oil, the trend is down. You've got lower highs, lower lows, an oversold condition. It's the flip-flop of what you've got in the beans and the meal. Resistance, 35.01, take out 35.05, and you negate this downtrend. When we come to the corn market, you have an inside trading day. If you look at the range today, it's not even, what is it, 2.5 cents? Unbelievably narrow range. If you take out 51, you might be challenging that 18-day average. I know a lot of people are talking that maybe this is going to be a bottom in the market. I don't know. You're not in the harvest yet. Wheat is still impressive in that it's trying to run against the upper Bollinger Band, but it is overbought and not trending. In the sugar market, 18-day average is going to be important, but more important than that is the sideways action that you're getting in the Bollinger Bands. This market's just churning right in here, not really giving you a heck of a lot to trend with. I'm going to guess that if you took out 14.16, you might make a run up to the 100-day average of 14.35, and if you can exceed that, maybe the 14.57 level. So interesting day in it, but nothing that I see that's revolutionary one way or the other in terms of a trend. Now, the coffee could give up its uptrend if it were to take out 136.50. What I'm guessing tonight is that the 18-day average is going to move up in price, and if you took that up,
you'd have lower highs, lower lows, which also means that whatever the number that is, that 18-day average, it should not, or it should, if it's tested, hold and not let the market get under 136.50. A close under whatever that 18-day average and 136.50 tomorrow does put the market in a downtrend. In the cocoa market, you keep trying to get over the upper Bollinger Band and fail. Market pulls back to the 100-day or the 18-day average looking for support, but it stays overbought. And in the cotton, you've had another breakout to the downside in this market. Now, until you take out yesterday's highs, are you going to make a run is the question for the lower Bollinger Band or not. You are oversold, but both numbers got under today 20. Yesterday, they were not that way. So it's the first day of being very oversold, but it's the beginning of the embedded process. In the cattle market, the odd cattle's having trouble at the upper Bollinger Band, as you'd expect, and it's overbought. It is still in an uptrend, and I'd look for support on pullbacks in the market. Feeder cattle, bullish, trying to just ride the upper Bollinger Band with an embedded reading. Remember, embedded means that a market in the slow stochastic oscillator converted itself from being overbought to now being bullish. And until the red line closes back under 80, I would expect to see what? Buyers on breaks. In addition, this market had a bullish crossover. That's when the shorter-term average, the 18-day average of closes, gets over the 100-day. It's exactly what occurred, and then the market made a new high after that. In the hogs, it seems like a bottomless pit here. This market just keeps coming down. It's oversold. It's under the lower Bollinger Band. Look for some support to develop because of that. Now, we write about all this in the Lynn research. And I mention this because we do our own research. We're not sitting there buying outside research, sending that out per se. Don't get me wrong. We have a few reports that we do. And for those of you that get our reports, you'll find that if you get into our research, you even get the Hightower reports, the Hall reports. You can get quite a few of the different ones that we have. But then we write so many of our own. And if you're an options trader, this is really important thinking, because we really write about who's doing what the strategies are, and things of that nature. We cover all these different markets. You can pinpoint which ones you want and not get the others in a free trial. Or if you're an account of ours, you can do it that way permanently as well. How do you get involved in all this? Well, it's pretty simple. You give us a call, 866-973-2077. You can always go to our website at www.iraepstein.com. You can click up here. If you see me on YouTube, all you need to do is from there click on the icon, or underneath us it says click here for Ira's free information. Do all that. We'll get things in your hand. I'm Ira Epstein. You have a good day.